Well, a new report is apparently showing Maryland could be doing much more to ensure the mentally ill don't have access to guns. The report is the result of a state commission bipartisan task force of law enforcement, mental health experts, and gun advocates. Among the 9 recommendations are mandates to at least temporarily seize firearms from those deemed dangerous by police, and a mandate for mental health professionals, educators, and social workers to report threats to themselves or others to police. But some state lawmakers don't think this report goes far enough. 11 News reporter George Lettuce joins us live now from the State House in Annapolis. He has more for us. George?
Well, Ryder, we actually spoke with the lawmaker who sponsored the bill to create that task force you were talking about. Delegate Simmons says that report simply scratches the surface of the problem, so he wants to dig deeper and focus on one specific part of the court system. Right now in Maryland, a person cannot buy a gun if they have ever been confined to a state mental institution for more than 30 consecutive days. The word consecutive is key here.
Well, what happens if someone in the course of a year had been committed over 100 days, but in increments of 10, 5, 20? Those records aren't examined. It's kind of cosmically absurd.
So State Delegate Louis Simmons wants to put tougher data collection requirements on the courts. When the new General Assembly convenes, he'll introduce a bill requiring a record of all court-ordered mental evaluations of people deemed a threat to themselves or others be sent to state police and the FBI to be included in background checks.
No, but we're not talking about going into some psychiatrist's office and asking for some guy's records. We're talking about people who have been at least court-ordered.
Simmons says Maryland lags far behind other states in this kind of record-keeping. After the Virginia Tech shooting, our neighbors to the south got aggressive.
Virginia is collecting and sending to the FBI over 2,300 court orders dealing with mental health evaluations per 100,000, where Maryland currently only sends about 6. We have a firearms problem in the state, and we need to make sure that individuals who have mental health issues do not automatically have access until they're properly vetted, and we're not properly vetting them.
Delegate Simmons' bill will be one of several to tackle gun control this upcoming session. We're live in Annapolis. George Lettuce, WBAL-TV 11 News.